getting something. Is there anyone in this room who has anyone that passed whose name begins with the letter J? The name John or James or Jerry is coming across strongly. And there was a fatal accident, maybe a car or an airplane or a tractor. There's a woman whose name begins with M. Maybe Mary or Marge. She's with John, and they're trying to relay a message from the other side. I believe the message is, wait, grow hair, don't be a bum. No, wait, it's dim, very faint. It's stay there, don't come, it sucks. It's dark all the time and there's no beer. Hey, that song was right. In heaven, there is no beer. Wait, they're saying it's not heaven, it's Chictawaga. When we die, we go to the suburbs. Does anyone in the studio want to claim these dead people because they're trying to get me to play Trivial Pursuit with them? And I'd rather die. I'd rather die than play live in the holiday spirit from the home of the future. It's the Greg Sterlace Show, starring Greg Sterlace, a man who leaves his body to go pick up snack food at Wilton Farms.
Well, the problem as I see it is we got two people sitting next to me with big attitudes, Bridget and Jim, and then we got someone who's nice over here, Brandon, right?
That's right.
You're nice. You're the only nice one. I got these two.
That's only on the outside.
It's only on the outside. Oh, so you're a prick on the inside?
No, I would not be that one.
No, you're a good guy.
I'm a nice guy.
Christian.
Yeah.
You're a Christian. We sure. Got the heathen here. We got another heathen here.
All right.
Okay. So Agent Me, is that Medical Examiner? Is that what I always thought it was? Medical Examiner.
Have we already started?
Yeah, we've started already.
Show's rolling, tape's going.
It's Medical Examiner or not?
No, it's just me.
Yeah, but what does that mean?
Originally,
Agent Me. It doesn't mean it's what's meaningless, right?
It's basically meaningless, but originally it was like
miming embryos. How about that?
Sure.
It's on the spot. Embryos. Why not?
And you guys play what, rock?
Yeah, we play straight up rock.
Straight up rock?
Yeah.
And what is that? Like Bad Company?
No. It could be like On the Rocks rock as opposed to straight up.
Straight up rock is like just riff rock?
Neil Diamond.
It's two guitar, band, drums, voices, basically.
It's catchy? Is it catchy?
It is catchy, I think. And, if you had to compare somebody in that, you know, the kind of Fuel-ish sort of.
It's just like Fuel?
Yeah.
Wow, that's great. I don't know any of their music, though. What are their big hits? They don't have any big hits, do they?
No, they do. It's
Really?
It's
they
like,
do?
They
have a song.
You're
called
our music expert, Bridget.
Sunburn.
You know, right?
Sunburn,
Shimmer.
Yes.
Oh, I love those songs! Those are great! You sound like that? Wow.
Similar. If we had to pick something, that's probably it.
Wow. I always like to find out on the show who's the leader. Who's the leader? Is it Ryan?
I think it's Jim.
Are you the leader, Jim?
I think we're four leaders. Ryan's the singer, though.
Oh, so he's the leader. So you guys are just nothing. He's the singer.
He's the singer, right. Right.
So
if you
guys
look at our website,
much,
you'll know.
I was afraid to.
Oh, yeah. Couldn't get the sticker off.
Actually,
right?
I don't have enough time to do that kind of stuff. I'm busy all the time, busy working and I'm writing and, you know, I'm making a movie.
Well, other than that, tell me a little more about your band.
No, seriously, I'm making a movie.
Yeah.
What's the movie about?
Don't plug anything here, okay? We got something else.
I really want to know about the movie, though.
Don't plug anything on my own show about myself. Okay, yeah, I'm making a movie about this guy, Ross Renfola. And this woman he's married to, Gwen Kears, and how they go through a lot of troubles. You know how couples go through a lot of troubles
sure.
over the years? And eventually, at the end, they get lobotomized by the government.
I like it.
It's thanks.
Are you shooting it in Buffalo?
Yeah, we're putting your music in it.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
It's a deal.
We're putting that song you do with Swingers. I love that song.
Can I be in it?
No, you can't be in it.
I want to be the lobotomizer.
We're only having one male... The sodomizer. You want to be the sodomizer in a movie?
Better
we're
going to
be sodomized by the state!
It's better than being the sodomizee.
That's always a bummer when the state decides. Well, you know, Buffalo, we're not going to be Buffalo anymore from now on. We're going to be Erie County!
Downtown County.
Mattiello's capitulating. You think he'd be happy being the only person who runs for mayor? I mean, that just make him happy enough, but now he becomes mayor. He says, we're not going to be Buffalo anymore.
Don't forget about
I know we have a tradition of 200-some years, but it's Erie County now!
There is the occasional attempted comeback by Jimmy Griffin, though.
He's been on the show twice.
Really?
Yeah. The last time he was on, we danced.
I love that.
We both had suits and ties on, and we got up and we did this kind of thing. And he was going, I'm doing this, and Jimmy's going, It was unbelievable. It was a moment of magic. He's a real prick, though. I mean, I asked him if I said, Jimmy, can we go to a baseball game together this summer? And he said, no, never with you, Greg.
Hey, at least he's honest, right?
No. That hurt, man.
You wanted to hear him say yes, even though he would have never actually followed through on it?
Over to, yes. I did want to hear, yeah, I mean, be polite. Politeness is a great thing.
I think honesty helps, too, though. No, you're right, he's a bastard.
Politeness, man. Oh, I noticed you got your painted nails there.
Yeah.
How androgynous of you.
Yeah.
Where'd you pick up that great color?
I don't know. I'm not exactly sure.
You must get a lot of chicks.
I would, but...
The Johnny Resnick hairdo is what gets all the chicks.
It's not only the Resnick hairdo. He's got the facial hair stuff. He's got the big metal thing in his chin. In his lip.
Lip,
yeah. Chin, whatever. So. Yeah.
They put that in him when he crossed the equator.
Isn't that the thing that Rosanna Arquette... Doesn't Rosanna Arquette have the thing in her lip for cunnilingus in the Pulp Fiction?
Oh, yeah.
Is that why you have it in there? Yeah.
No.
When you give oral sex to people, you have to have the...
I think that's the tongue ring.
Oh, Tom, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
What about you? You're the clean-cut one, Brandon.
Sure, man.
Why, you know, this guy's like, you know, he's like drudgy, sludgy.
Well, I don't need to show off.
No, you're all talented.
You have
a
hole in your crotch. Almost,
yeah, I noticed that.
Right near your dick.
Yep. Hey,
wow.
What are you going to do?
You don't need to show off, though.
No. There's nothing to show off.
And what is that, Brill Cream? Brill Cream 46? That's good stuff.
Afro-Sheen.
Really?
Yeah.
Afro-Sheen?
Yeah.
Soul Glow.
I'm working on it.
Really? You look. Yeah. That looks good.
Thanks.
You never thought about going with like just regular hair?
No.
You always do that every day when you wake up?
That's right.
Really? All day long? Do you have to re-moose it later on?
No, believe it or not, it'll last
all day. What is that, activator? Water in it later?
Yeah, do you like pour like
it's just like new.
You got to pour like Kool-Aid on it later and it perks up again? Is that what happens? You're getting all red. Look how red he is.
I know. Hey, what are you going
to
do?
You don't need to show off, man.
I don't think he's used to being on TV.
No, who is?
You?
Well, let's have the two of you talk to the greatest person alive, Ross Funfola.
Could I see the ID number on that lock?
I don't know where it is.
Why? Well, you stole my bike 2 years ago.
Can I see the ID number on that tie?
No. No. What the hell is this?
I think it's a...
I was told you don't like food.
I don't like most food.
Yeah?
It's you the like, taste. I have to kill it with hot sauce in order to eat it.
Yeah, you put hot sauce on Brandon's ass, don't you?
No. I don't eat ass.
No. You don't eat his ass.
I'm
you
adamant about that.
Put hot sauce on his ass. Huh?
No, I try to avoid it. See, Brandon...
Oh, I'm sorry. You put yogurt on his ass.
No. The yogurt's for his feet, actually. You would be surprised. He's got those Irish feet. You know what I mean? The toes that go...
Well, I saw the way you were sitting there, so obviously you can perform oral sex on yourself, can't you?
I wish. I wouldn't be here talking to you now if I could.
Then you wouldn't have to date. Okay,
no,
thanks.
I wouldn't.
Thanks, buddy.
Brandon?
Yes, sir.
I'm glad you called me sir.
Yeah, no problem.
Because I was in the service. Do you understand, Brandon?
Were you?
Yes. Marines. Do I look like a Marine?
No.
Why?
Because you don't. Because you look weak, man.
Real weak?
Real weak.
Okay, Brandon.
I'm supposed to choke myself.
I heard you have an obsessive compulsive disorder. You have an obsessive compulsive disorder.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay, I'm sorry.
So you could never be in the Marines because you pack the band stuff 7 times and then you check it 10 times, don't you?
I do.
What the hell's the deal here, Brandon?
Hey, gotta be thorough.
No, but you don't have to be thorough. You check it 100 times at one gig you had in Chicago.
Oh, what the hell, man! First it was 4 to 10 times. Now it's 100.
Well, I'm glad you dressed up.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, because
what is this? The Talking Heads?
No. We're talking Small Heads.
Small Heads. Okay.
Okay, Brandon, we're done with you.
Okay.
And now we're going to go back to how many more band members do we have?
That's it.
You
can't see him now. Go ahead. Say back to me.
Back to Greg Sterlace to see what witty, clever things he has to say. I can hardly wait.
Okay, Merry Hanukkah to everybody out there. Happy.
Kwanzaa.
He's searching.
Happy.
So, back to this band thing.
Happy.
Let me ask you little things about yourself.
Happy.
Do you guys have girlfriends?
I do, yes.
Bummer. What about you?
Yeah.
Bummer! What the hell am I doing on this show if I can't get a date?
Well, you mean you can still...
Well, you didn't ask Brandon that question. Why not?
Well, because Mr. Big Mouth right here was sucking up the whole first half of the show.
So you're saying you're not Ms. Big Mouth? Is that what you're implying? That you're the subtle one?
I'm the pretty one.
Oh, you're the pretty one, of course. So if there was a really handsome man here, would he be pretty?
No, he'd be hot. But we'll just stick with you, Greg.
Thank you.
So you guys got started
Did you ask Jim about his boyfriend thing? Did you ask
no, Jim, do you have a girlfriend?
And he's so sexy. He's the one who you think would get all the chicks.
He deny it.
Well, the two of you can still have sex with Bridget. You just don't, you know, you want to stay with your relationship, right?
Just not on the show, not in front of the camera.
Yeah, well, you can stay with your relationship and have sex on the side, right? You guys are real men. Am I right?
I'm all for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I only have sex with band members who are drummers, so
Who's the drummer? All right!
Oh,
so you get to have sex
with the baby! Excellent. Yeah!
Wow. And he's only 16, huh?
Yeah, whatever.
16, 15.
You're 15. 15. Now, how old are you really?
Mary Kate Laterna could do it, so can
20.
I.
20.
20?
Yeah.
So you are. Is that jailbait still, Bridget?
No.
At 20?
It's 18.
Oh. But still, he's pretty young. He's a drummer. He pounds.
Yeah.
You only sex with the drummers?
He's
going to have sex with you off. You know, no, he's not going to break up with his girlfriend, though, right? You're going to stay with her.
Oh, my God, yeah.
But you're going to have sex with Bridget on the side.
Oh, I can't do that.
Would you?
Oh. It's the rhythm. Come on. Sorry.
Come on.
Hello, you're a
but
band.
But off the record, though, you'll do it, right? Off the record.
You're a band.
I know. He's
come on.
Just say you will.
How long have you been dating your girlfriend?
Almost 2 years.
So, like, since high school?
No. That's what do you mean, since?
Yeah, high school, because he's only 20.
Yeah, I know.
So he's 18.
So you know how long that's going to last?
Senior year?
Not long.
It's over, man.
And me?
It's over.
How long
are you getting married?
About a year.
What?
And how old are you? 23?
24.
Oh, that's going to work.
This is the first time we ever had two conversations about relationships going on at the same time. don't stop. Don't ever stop.
Do you ski in these pants? Are they waterproof?
They're vinyl.
You getting married, you said?
Sooner or later.
Did you? Oh, really? So you're totally madly in love, then?
Yeah, she's an awesome girl.
Wow. How are you going to propose?
Oh, I don't know.
Get down on your knees and...
I don't know. I don't want to talk about it.
You probably want to wait until after the legal...
You don't want to talk about it. So you love this woman madly, but you don't want to talk about how you're going to propose to her?
When's your birthday?
Mine?
Yeah.
Mine is January 23rd. Mm. Well, so I got a little...
That's really a pussy-ass birthday, Tom.
Yeah,
why
is
that a pussy-ass birthday? I think it's a damn good birthday.
No, it's pretty kick-ass. I'm sorry. What about you, Ryan?
The Water Bearers, man. Aquarius.
The Water Bearers?
Yeah.
Aquarius. I'm Aquarius. Let's not even.
Yeah, I used to have a girlfriend who was Aquarius. Yeah.
And then she turned lesbian?
No, she got married to a philosophy professor.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And then my girlfriend after that, she got married to a philosophy professor. Isn't that amazing? And then they worked together. The two philosophy professors worked together.
Well, you're just giving them out, aren't you?
What about you?
What about me, what?
When's your
you're
birthday?
You're getting married?
December 8th.
December 8th.
Oh, yeah,
the day John Lennon got shot?
No, it was the
what
7th.
What the?
That was the 7th. And
it was the 8th,
it
man. December 8th.
It was
December 8th. December 7th, Pearl Harbor. It was December 8th, man. You're a jinx.
Dude,
it was December 8th at 11 man. 1980.
Don't hurt him. Are you okay?
December 7th, my ass.
Oh
that
my
was Pearl Harbor.
Get your damn hands off. McFly.
Are you okay?
Are you okay, Ryan? I didn't mean to touch you. Sorry about that.
A little shaken up.
This shirt's nice.
I got a little emotional.
Yeah, I wasn't pulling out any of the stops for today. I pulled out the vinyl pants and the silk shirt.
Yeah, I see.
Nice shoes, too.
You know where that
Skechers.
Shirt, you know where that shirt will look good
is
at.
Is that Plagola?
Crumpled up on my bed in the morning.
Oh.
Yeah.
Todd, never
wear... I know.
Todd, never wear an undershirt or a t-shirt under an undershirt.
Oh, you got to.
No, that's wrong. That's
Jim's
wrong.
Motto.
That's because you have a sweating
like
problem.
I don't have
cute
a sweating
boys
problem.
Like this can wear whatever they want.
I don't have a sweating problem in my face. My face is sweating all the time. Oh, hold on. Sorry.
Yeah, that's so attractive. Wondering why your girlfriends ran away.
Next thing you know, he's be picking wedgies and stuff up here.
But your boss is going to shut the hell up.
He said, shut the hell up.
I don't care what he said, man.
So back to the band. Where's your next show at?
Well, that's interesting. It was just canceled. So
yeah. Oh God, you guys
we're gonna play a New Year's Eve show, but
where
we're gonna do a Chippewa gig, but that was canceled.
Just on a street?
Yeah, and there was going to be a festival and we were gonna play it, but
but then they found out how much Buffalo sucks. Then no one would probably
Buffalo's
be there.
Buffalo's a great town.
Yeah.
The two of you, Buffalo's I'm gonna do a you a big town. Favor now. I'm gonna let you talk to Marine Drill Sergeant Ross T. Runfola. Colonel Ross T. Runfola.
Colonel.
So do we have to call him sir?
Todd, this has got to be a real quick interview because I have a date with a hot chick by the name of Christine Russell.
Oh, someone's going to die. Someone's going to die, and I think it's going to be you.
Really?
Yeah.
She said, get him on the show so I can meet you later, Ross.
Okay? Oh, did she now?
Yeah. Right now, she's at my house.
Is she?
Yeah.
Well, I'll talk to her. I'll have a little talkings to her.
Oh, I feel badly about it.
Hey. You know, I'm surprised you still have your regular shoes on, because I'm going to get some cement shoes in a second.
No. The relationship. The relationship is over. I'm going to put it on live TV.
No.
Nice seeing you, Tad.
Nice seeing you too. Cement shoes.
Ryan, do you know why your gig was canceled on New Year's Eve?
Ryan, text him.
Well,
are we on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we're on.
Oh, okay.
Do I know why it was canceled?
Yeah.
Are you going to say because we suck?
No, I was going to say...
I
was going to say because you're out of the band, okay, and they don't know how to tell you. Okay, this is like the Beatles. You're finished.
Now back to somebody, Ross.
Don't
go!
We're now going to go back to Greg Sterlacci, who's replacing Greg Sterlacci this thing.
All right, now straight from the North Pole, we have the South Pole. We have the East Pole.
No, it's the North
Pole.
Now
direct from the West Pole, we have Amy the Elf. And you look nice there with your ho-ho-ho hat on.
My hat.
You got the stars and the bars on your snowman. And so what's the problem? Santa couldn't bring himself to make an appearance in the show. It was too much for his raggedy ass.
Oh, yeah, he wanted me to tell you he was sorry, but it's only 4 days before Christmas, and he still has lots of stuff to do, but he wanted me to, he sent me to wish everybody Merry Christmas, and...
Can I book him in January?
Sure. He'd probably be able to make it in January.
Because you know who's coming on in January is, who comes on every year for his birthday, J.D. Salinger. He's going to be 82.
Wow.
And he's coming on, and maybe he and Santa can, see, I think the sparks will fly with him and Santa.
You know yeah, great.
Two of them together.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So are we gonna do that number we've been working on for a few weeks now, that Jingle Bells number?
You mean the one you were just singing a minute ago?
Sounds good.
Yeah, we worked on it at work today.
Oh, I'm sure you did.
We did. We also worked on Silent Night, Holy Night.
Mm-hmm.
Last week we had a great Jingle Bells song. Oh. It was the Gothic Jingle Bells. It was really scary.
Oh,
we have a phone call, Amy the Elf.
Hello.
Come
Hello,
in.
I'd like to speak to Osama bin Sterlace, please.
This is Osama bin Sterlace. How did you find me in hiding?
Osama bin Sterling.
This is me, yes. Go ahead.
This is Amir from Karachi, Pakistan, calling.
Hi, Amir.
I am calling from Karachi.
Mm.
I wanted to let you know that we do not celebrate the Christmas holiday in Pakistan.
Why not? What are you, non-Christians there?
That's correct, Greg.
What religion do you practice?
That is correct.
What religion do you practice? Hinduism?
I'll tell you what I practice.
Aztecism?
Well, I
Judaism?
I work in the hotel business.
All you people work in hotels, I've noticed.
Yeah, that was a funny one.
I practice Ramadan.
Ramadan?
Yes.
That's so you work at the Ramada Inn and you practice Ramadan? That's not a religion.
Yes.
You know, I don't know what religion is, sir.
Yes, well...
Are you coming to kill me? Because I'm waiting here in the bunker. I mean, cave, sorry.
No, how could I kill somebody that wears socks like you do?
Yeah, that's true.
I mean it.
Thank you.
They're ankle-high white socks.
Would you like to make love to me?
Oh, boy. Well, in...
Is that a yes? Can I take it as a yes, sir?
In Pakistan, sir...
Is that a yes, sir?
Okay.
Okay. When can we get it out?
I will try and arrange it the next time I'm in the United States.
And when will that be?
You
got a valid passport?
You, Osama.
Huh? Eh? What?
Well, hopefully, I will try and make it the next time I come into the
When are you coming? So you can come with me.
Oh.
When is it? Maybe in the springtime? We can see a ball game together because Jimmy Griffin won't go with me.
Okay. Thank you very much. That's a very good plan.
Okay. I guess you don't want to talk to me if we're talking about making love together, huh?
Okay.
All right. I understand. You ready?
Merry Christmas.
You want to sing Jingle Bells with us?
Yes.
We're going to do Jingle Bells. Ready? Let's all do it together.
Okay.
Bridget's sitting this one out, I think. Are you sitting this one out or are you going to join in?
I don't think so.
Who is the guest host?
I'm Jewish.
The guest host is Bridget.
It's actually Brigitte.
Brigitte.
It's French.
Brigitte. She's French.
Are you from France?
Yeah, she is from France.
Oh, Brigitte.
She's from West France.
But I shower and I shave.
But she showers and shaves. Unlike
you
Palestinians.
Arms,
damn
Brigitte?
Palestinians.
Yeah.
Wow. Really?
Get out of there,
but you're picking your arms up. I'm not
you braid the hair under your arms, Brigitte.
That turns them on in Palestine.
I mean, if that's what you like, I guess.
She can do it for you, she said. If you're a drummer. Are you a drummer, sir?
I
Are you a little drummer boy?
I only make out with drummers. It's like a thing.
She only makes out with drummers.
Yes, I'm a drummer.
I'm sure you are.
He is. What a coincidence. Isn't that amazing?
Crazy. Yeah.
You say you only make a lot of drummers, and he turned out to be a drummer. What a... That's a fluke. It's like a million to one chance.
You're a dumbass.
I'm a drummer from Karachi.
I'm a dumbass?
No, this guy's a dumbass.
Oh, he's a dumbass? Well, he's going to sing Jingle Bells with us anyways. Right, dumbass?
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
dumbass. Ready? Here we go. You, me, and Amy from... Amy from South Buffalo. North Pole. The West Pole. Ready? Okay, let's take it way down. Ready?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh.
Hey!
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Hey! Dashing through the snow in a one horse open sleigh. Through the fields we go, laughing all the way.
Ha ha ha!
Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to laugh and sing in a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
I can't hear you, dumbass. Where's dumbass? Jingle bells, jingle. Get in, jump in here, dumbass.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride one horse open sleigh.
Hey.
Does anyone remember laughter? Let's talk to Ross Rinfola now. Let Amy talk to Ross Rinfola.
Amy, it's near Christmas, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It's a festive season.
Away.
Yeah, 4 days away. Now, I'm dressed in a festive way, aren't I?
Yes, you look
very
nice.
Why aren't you dressed in a festive way?
Well, I got my holiday sweater vest and my holiday...
I got my holiday tie, my holiday suit. Do you like it?
Yeah, it's very nice.
What does your hat say, Amy?
Oh, it says ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho?
Yep.
Can I have...
My sweater vest is Noel.
Can I have the sweater vest? Because I didn't buy a gift for my mother.
Oh.
She's about your size. I don't give a shit. You know? I don't buy things for my family. Do you?
Oh, yeah, I usually do.
Give me $20 then?
Well, afraid I don't have much money left now.
Whatever you have, I'm taking, okay, Amy?
Shopping.
Whatever you have, I'm getting. Okay. Well, Amy, we'll talk about the deal in the kitchen, okay? And now we're going back to Greg Bin Laden and the beautiful Brigitte.
Okay, now we're back with diversity.
Agent me, dumbass.
Pull the switch.
Well, yeah, agent me, of course, but I mean, now we're doing the diverse thing by having the two least... Exciting members. They're on together now.
What? I grabbed this guy's breast earlier.
His nipple?
Yeah.
His larps?
His man boobs. Larps.
Does he have nice nipples?
I don't really have
much. He's got a
great
shirt.
They're like dime size, so they're not...
They're not good?
Look at this shirt. It's so...
What do you need, quarter size?
His nipples are Irish.
Well, no, I think a normal... the normal size is probably nickel size, wouldn't you say?
I would have to assume.
Oh, so you got the tiny nipples.
Yeah, they're, you know...
That's going to say...
He's in the IBTC.
Eh?
The itty-bitty... Committee. You know?
You just made that up?
No,
I don't
think
so.
I thought that was an older
that
one.
That was like a sixth grade thing.
I think that's kind of
never heard it.
You guys study history, obviously.
Yeah. That's right. That's right.
You're students of history.
It's like pop culture. Suburbs. Yeah, you know, it's it's like the skanky version of pop culture.
Do you know all the presidents of the United States?
In order?
No, just out of order, but do you know them all?
I think I do.
Okay, go ahead, Jim.
Do you got the time?
This is ought to be
Why are you doing kind of quickly?
We got George W., Bill Clinton, George the First.
George the First? That's a,
well, his father, you know who he is.
Oh,
Reagan.
George Bush?
Yeah,
oh,
okay. George Bush. George right. Herbert Walker Bush. Then we have Ronald Reagan. Before him, we have Jimmy Carter. Before him, we have Gerry Ford. Before him, we have Richard Nixon. Before him, we have Lyndon Johnson. Before him, we have JFK. Before him, we have Eisenhower. Before him, Truman. Before Truman,
Capote.
His father is a history teacher.
Go ahead.
Oh, this is a cheater. His dad's a history teacher.
That doesn't mean he's cheating. He still knows it.
Well, my dad still knows. He doesn't have crib notes.
Yeah. My dad's not a history teacher now, I'll tell you that.
Why? Is he dead?
Yes. Yeah, I'm a little orphan boy.
Really?
No, I think he's in jail.
Does that mean you're an orphan if your father dies?
Well, my mom's dead, too.
Does that make you an orphan?
I think that's what makes you an orphan.
Oh, my phone's ringing.
Aren't you an adult, though?
I don't... Well, I am now.
Oh, you were always an orphan then since a little...
No. I think for a while I was a latchkey kid.
Wait, are you kidding? Your parents are really...
Deceased.
Yeah. Yeah, dead.
But that's why he's so rocking.
That's why Christmas is so easy every year.
Wow, no family?
Less presents every single year.
No family,
unless you
know?
Count grass seed as a present.
And you know, sometimes it's bothers
this guy is
he
so
go, he goes on about how his parents are dead.
Yeah.
I know.
Is it? Are you wearing a badge of honor?
I put the fun, yeah, I put the fun back in funeral.
You put the fun back in funeral?
No, I'll say something like, that's my beautiful. Dad stopped by, and he'll go, yeah, my dad stopped by once, but he's dead now. And then you feel all bad. You're just like, my dad called. Yeah, my least, dad called, too.
At least with the people that I know, I have the market cornered on parental death humor.
Yeah.
I don't know anybody else who can do the parental death humor.
You've got it all, man.
As well. I try.
Wow. Boy, and I thought you were one of the least exciting members of the band. But now, seeing that your parents are dead and you know most of the presidents from the 20th century, late 20th century, that's...
I went to I got to
you know,
the 40s.
You know anything about the 19th? What about the 19th century?
The 19th
Besides
century?
Besides Lincoln, of course.
Besides Lincoln
that's
and...
So, and Andrew Jackson. Those are easy.
I'm done. I don't know anything about any other one.
So you know George Washington, you know Thomas
but
Jefferson.
I know Benjamin Harrison.
Who?
Benjamin Polk. Harrison.
Polk.
Not George Harrison.
Never heard of him.
Polk.
What about McKinley? You must know McKinley.
McKinley died in 1900 in the fair city of Buffalo.
All right. Anyways, clip.
At the Pan American Exposition.
We're wholesome members, I think. I have to say off the top of my head, you know, we got Mr. Monogamous here. And we got, well, you're the cleanest cut of the four.
Monogamous.
So, you know. But all I can say is I hope that the two of you live long, happy lives. And
thank you.
Thank you very much.
I hope both of you never die, really, to tell you the truth.
Thank you.
I'd love to see you both live forever. So, Bridget, why'd you come on the show? Because last time when I called you, I told you never to come here, and you showed up tonight. What the? Did you decide it's?
I'm getting free dinner.
You're getting free dinner from Ross?
Yep.
So Ross called you up and said, "I know you don't want to come on Greg's show, but I'm gonna buy
no,
you free
actually,
dinner."
No, actually, he was saying something about this film he was making. I was like, "Oh yeah, I'll help out." And then he mentioned your show, and I'm like, "Meh, I really wasn't gonna do it, but."
Yeah, and you did a bad job, don't you think?
I'd rather do a bad job than have sweaty face syndrome. So
well,
I don't know.
That's
Oh,
I don't say it. I already admitted the sweaty face thing. I've already gone through it. I even touched myself before.
Yeah, sweaty face is better
Let's
than jungle ass. So.
Yeah, right.
No, he's got that too.
I have that too.
Oh,
and I have
ass.
Herpes.
Stub eraser. And her,
damn.
Syphilis.
And syphilis.
Gonorrhea.
And
gangrene of the asshole.
And pancreas.
The drip.
And the drip.
And the clap.
And now we're going to listen to what? Wasted Away, right?
That's
yes,
right,
sir.
Man.
On your great album.
Rockstar.
Rockstar.
This That's is right. Agent Me coming at ya.
Clip.